Hi, so I'm back for series two of how to do self-massage or self-massage on your feet using various tools. So hopefully this time it will be a bit quieter. I had my son here last time asking about lawn mowing and different things, but he's having a sleep. So we'll see if we can get some work done and I can talk to you about it. So today I'm going to show you a bit more about how to use oil with foot massage on self-massage. So I'm going to use this frankincense and myrrh. It's like a foot pain relief oil for people with diabetes or neuropathic pain. That up close. And I really like it. It's got different essential oils and homeopathic remedies. So what I do is just usually get my feet and my foot all oily. And one of the tools that I like, as well as this one, which I was showing in my last video, is we can, you know, while I was holding points, but you can actually slide this one as well. So I like this tool as well. This is a Thai massage tool, and we can do more sliding. I can combine it with this a bit more. This time more into these areas that are so important, which are the very tips of the toes. It's been pretty amazing weather here. I've been in St. Louis now for 6 or 7 weeks. Maybe 8. And it's been like 25, 26 degrees centigrade today, which is like 80 Fahrenheit. Whereas a few weeks ago it was negative 26 centigrade, or like negative 10 or something. Fahrenheit is amazing. It's all winter, but it's like so varied. In fact, it was snowing a week ago. You know, mountain shorts, it was quite warm. So, unusual. Anyway, it's great. Nice winter's day. So, really getting into here with the tip of this tool and working in. So all these bits of tightness, so very important area, like I said, right in here. You can hold that and then just start to kind of caress down at the pressure that you can handle. Okay, and the same on this side, we can start to come in there, right along the side of the toe. Obviously, when you've got oil, it is harder to both hold a tool and to get precision, you know, so there's benefits to oil and there's things that are not so good with oil. Sometimes I like to work the very tip of the toe without oil just because you can hold it easier. But if it's not too much, you can still work around it, get into the sides of the toe. And my feet aren't like model feet, you know, to be in a foot model show or something, because they've been working maintenance feet. I was actually a furniture removalist for a few years. Been on my feet a lot of farming as well. And then living near the ocean, beaches and stuff. So, I've had a bit of a pounding, but putting oil on them is very good because they get quite dry. And then just getting in with this tool. So I found some really good spots right here, and I can move the toe right into the tool and deep breathe into it. Okay, and then I can move the tool around. Okay, so just work at whatever you can handle, you know, and then I can come into the other toes. I think if you can do a lot of work yourself, and it just saves you a lot of money hiring a therapist. But if you do want to learn, Now that I'm in the States, got my green card. Got a course coming up in Vermont in June. I might have another one in September if I got enough people interested. Otherwise, I might do like Minnesota or somewhere. And then I'm teaching in Australia in May and New Zealand next year. And of course, my other teachers teach in other parts of Canada and the United Kingdom. Again, we can use this tool to get that precision work, especially with the toes and everything, and just get that oil deeply into the skin. Right under there. Oh, if you can feel like a band of tension, this is what I call bands. They actually come from the very tip here and come down through here. You'll feel with a good tool like this, you can feel a lot of little crunchy bits. It feels like grains of sand. That's the origins or start of a lot of the tension. Oh, if you have arthritic toes or really tight toes, you can spend hours and it'll take years of tension off of your life and add like so many good quality years to your life. Think getting rid of tension is one of the primary aspects of health and longevity. Then again, we can, like I say, use this one as we start to come into this part of the foot, scraping too. This tool is good because you can change it around as well and use points like follow down that working. Heels and that sort of thing up here, and any calluses, of course. Come into here. Little toes can be amazingly sensitive and tight, so just give it a good work over. And again, with this tool, it really doesn't let tension escape. I've just been using these over the last couple of years. And taking the place of some of the chopsticks. But you can still use Japanese chopsticks with a rounded edge as well. But these, like, you can really feel all the little gritty bits. So in reflexology, these areas relate to your head, sinuses, that sort of thing. But I mostly just like consider them also to be the roots of tension. Like how the roots of a tree become tiny. So tension becomes tiny where it's held, and as it goes higher up in the body, it becomes much bigger. Can hold and push from the other side, coming down. Again, if you hit a sensitive spot like this one's sensitive for me, oh, take a deep breath. Just breathe into it. Caress through there. Oh. And just at what you can handle. Hold spots. Oh. Fingers in. Again, just feeling anywhere that's holding tightness. Getting right in and caressing that. Hands, toes, and the hands. pain. Really get in, finding anything you can. Paying a special attention to the inside of the big toe, because that's where people hold a lot of tightness. Right along the edge here. But you can also do the front of your toes. So that's right here. This area is quite sensitive. I do like to use oil on the top of my foot, but I usually don't use any tools through here. I just use my fingers because of the sensitivity. And how we can work that is just to like this. Right up into the top. And feeling any tension that you're holding, especially that tendon that comes from the big toes. Tension starts right in there. It's really great learning to work on your own feet, even if you're a therapist, because you're going to learn a lot about what it feels like for other people. So big toes are really important. I like to work right in under here. All through this area. Combining with deep breathing. So we can always remember too that tension holds toxins. So when we release the tension, the toxins go back into our bloodstream. Be filtered out by our organs. I find deep breathing just helps relax the body too. And it's very, very tight as it is on almost everybody I work on is tight through this part of their big toe. And we can do some great moves for this joint. A lot of people get kind of an arthritic area around this joint in particular. So we can just work, release any tension we're holding in there. So order is important because doing the tips of the toes first and the toes is going to serve you much better when it comes to working more into the foot. You'll find that as the more you do this, the less sensitive it becomes, or even just within a few minutes. Less sensitivity. You can get in there deeper. Great thing about this tool is you can even use the edge if you want something more sharp. good to empower yourself and have some of your own tension. This is quite a tight spot for me. Actually, when I feel like it's near my pain threshold, I can just hold it, breathe into it, or wiggle it around a bit, and that helps to let go. And I move just even a millimeter. Oh, I've got this fibroma over here. It's a benign fibroma, plantar fibroma. It's called plantar in his foot. And it makes it a bit sensitive around there. But I've tried massaging it out. It doesn't really work. But it hasn't. It's supposed to help a little bit. So again, I can hold the tool. Deep breathe into that. Oh. And again, move another few millimeters. Or whatever, 1/18 of an inch or something in the imperial system. I still haven't figured out why Americans had a revolution, but then kept the imperial system of measurement. The world didn't have many revolutions that got rid of the imperial system, except for England, where it's half and half. So I really just moving your toe around while so important, I think, to keep this joint flexible. When I was doing a lot of lawn mowing back in Australia, those of you that followed the last video know my 2-year-old loves lawn mowing with me. And we have mowed this lawn since I did that last video, for those that are interested. But anyway, doing a lot of lawn mowing on a hill puts a lot of pressure on this joint. One of my favorite moves here is actually holding in between the on the side of that toe bone. I find burping to be a release of energy as well, or whatever we call it. Some people don't like that word energy, but English has only so many words for certain things. Oh, Chinese, of course, use things like qi, you know, for life energy. Okay, so given that bottom of that big toe, quite a good workout, actually. Get in a bit more into here. Into here. I can come again and do a bit more in here. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, you're so mean, Brandon. There we go. I got to whinge and whine like some of the people I work on. 6 inches. Okay, so just holding that spot. Moving slowly when it's what I call charged. Again, English is a funny language, doesn't seem to have the best words. You know, in certain Eskimo languages, I think they have 100 words for snow. Like in English, we have one word for like pain, but there's good pain, there's bad pain, there's awareness, there's all sorts of words that we really should have. And looking at why does the body become tight? What is it that makes tightness? Is it like a gas, like when a gas gets compressed in a tire, it becomes hard? Or is it something more subtle? Because obviously people have a lot of emotional releases. So how does emotions in the body fit in? You know, it's pretty fascinating, the mind-body-spirit connection. And, ever since my father died last year, I've been thinking quite a lot about death, leaving the body. But I'm going to try and crank a bunch of more years out of this one if I can, before I head off. Especially with a couple of young kids. But it'd be interesting to see. That's why I thought, well, I'll take some time out teaching and work on myself. You can see that nice line that's coming through there, actually, where I've been working. I'm not going that easy on myself. But the good thing about working on yourself is that you can gauge exactly the right amount of pressure. So if 10 is your maximum, you can go right up to a 9.9 or a 10. And then just breathe into it, let it go. Or sometimes when other people are working on you, especially if you have sensitive feet, like mine can get sometimes. Sometimes it's a bit like, you get a bit jumpy with people working on them. Oh, this is intense. Oh! So just again, folding. You can see already they've dried out too from that oil sulfur some more oil, I'd say. But right now, I'm just wanting to really loosen this area up. Yeah, that's really charged. That's the what I call the Achilles band coming through here and into the back here of Achilles. And that's very tight, I think. Sensitive through there as well. So you can just hold a spot that's sensitive and breathe into it. Some people will get emotional, might have, you know, especially if you've got some recent, like, sadness or anger or something like that. Best thing is just breathe into it and let it go if that comes up. I'm not feeling that right now for me, but whatever. You got to have what I call a non-judgmental frame of mind to whatever it is that's going on. That way you can just breathe into it, let it go if it's held in your body. Okay, so again, I can get it deeper rather than just push it in deeper. I can move my foot into the tool and then again come down.